Hello, hello, welcome back to another video on the channel where healing and spiritual growth are front and center. This video shout out goes to a Val Star. Thank you for your continued support. I'm going to dive into a reminder for those who need this one, and then also for those who are still trying to understand what God means in Jude 1:4 by where he tells us there will be many crept in unawares, because this is a big one. And it took it took myself a little while for it to sink in as well. Right? Because it really was one of those things, like, how can a person not know they are living in fear? All right? But as always, you know, before you get lost in the message, you'll go tackling another task while listening. Let's make sure we give the video a thumbs up so that other fellow chosen survivors can get the message as well. Thank you in advance. And so this is important, because when God tells us in Jude 1:4 that, you know, there will be many crept in unawares, right, that covers a lot of things, okay? Crept in unawares that they're a narc, crept in unawares that they're trauma bonded to the world, crept in unawares that they are being narcissistically abused on the societal level, unaware that they themselves are very much traumatized. They also are engaging in a lot of the abusive, narcissistic abusive behaviors, all right, crept in unawares, all right, about that, about some of them, not all of them. Now, they know, all right, they know when they're trying to manipulate, but as far as the complaining and the gossiping and stuff like that, they're crept in unawares that we're not supposed to be doing that. They're crept in unawares they even have the Asian mindset. They're crept in unawares they even have a scarcity mindset. Okay, they're crept in unawares about it. And they're crept in unawares that they lack faith because they're living in fear. See, remember that, you all. If you're living in fear, that is a lack of faith. That really is a massive goal of the enemy. It's to keep people living in fear so they don't have faith. Because what do we need to be doing? Yes, walking and living by faith. All right? And so that will let us know when we recognize that they're living in fear. And I'm going to give y'all some examples. Okay? If they express anything, okay, just to help y'all now. You might want to get your notebook, whatever. Go come back. All right? But if they express any kind of worry about something, okay, if they express any kind of worrying about something, that's stemming from fear. Okay, if they are, let's say they look at you with big wide eyes and they are complaining about, let's say, the rising of something. Okay, quote unquote, part of the world stage thingy. All right, quote unquote. They're living, that's a scarcity mindset. So if they express anything that had to do with that, and that lets you know they've got the scarcity mindset, that lets you know they're living in fear. All right. If they and automatically you'll know if they're living in fear, then that means they're lacking faith. All right. They think they know God and they think they're worshiping God, but they're not. Because to truly fear and worship God is to walk and live by faith. Okay, faith that God is working it all out, that God is making a way, right? Faith, right? Because that's not only faith in God, but trust in God. And then in turn, that trust in yourself. Okay, there you go, that you're going to get it done. And that all things, will seek ye first the kingdom of God, and all things shall be added unto you. Okay, but see, they don't know this, okay? Because they have been programmed to stay trauma bonded to the world, trauma bonded to certain matrices, what they think is real. And I'm talking about, y'all, I'm talking about when they get older, okay? We're not talking about the ones that God had yet to wake up, okay? Yes, there's other chosen ones that God had not awakened yet. So we want to keep that in mind when viewing these videos on the channel. We are referring to those who have made the choice, okay, to live in narcissism, all right? That's the best way to put it, is to live, and they chose narcissism, all right? Meaning they conform to this world. And so through your discernment, you will know, okay, anytime, because it's anything that they may try to do to instill fear. That lets you know that the enemy has access to them, Okay? So if the enemy has access to them, all right, because they're trying to dish out that fear, then that should tell you pretty much all that you need to know. All right? And so we don't want to let y'all, you know, get, you know, lost in all that, or you learn not to be affected by it, okay? Just like I said in the previous video about, you know, learning, practicing, turning off that empathy switch so that it doesn't get in there and try and trick you, okay? And I will share with you all a quick example, okay, of how I, you know, how I sent it to help y'all put it. And I'm not the only one, okay? There's several of you fellow warriors who experienced the exact same thing. And then I knew instinctively that it was coming from them, not me. And I knew it wasn't mine, because I knew something was off when a certain thing happened. Right? I knew something was off about the whole thing. And that's when I went down there. That's when God had me go down the rabbit hole. Okay, I knew something was off. And I was like, something's off about this. But I sensed an enormous amount of that. And I was like, but it wasn't me. I was like, because I trust God. I was like, you know, I was already, by that time, I was already at the point where I was like, I trust God. It's in His hand. You know, I mean, there was no reason. I mean, remember, God already awakened me. A lot of us were already in the spiritual awakening. Okay? Not the other, quote unquote, awakening that I speak about over on the Patreon channel. There's a difference. The true blue spiritual awakening. Okay, you know, many of us were already in it when that happened. That's why we were able to sense something was off about it. Something was just totally off. And we're like, okay. And so we started to realize that, okay, that's not coming from us. And so when I sensed it, it was just, it was like my warning bell went off. Big time. I mean, loud and clear. Okay, the warning bell's just boom. And so I was like, okay, wait, what's up? Where's that coming from? You know, so I was like, okay. And so now I know, okay. It didn't take long for God to reveal that to me as to where it was coming from, okay? And so they and then they'll claim that they're not living in fear when they are, because they don't realize that they are living in fear, okay? Seriously. So that's why we don't point it out to them. But there's no point. We learned that lesson. The hard way. We learned that lesson. Okay? And just remember that. Your spiritual eyes and your spiritual ears will pick up on it. Okay? Anything that is stems from that fear, you'll know. Okay? You'll know. And so, after that, you'll understand. That, okay, because it's not you. You trust God. And with God, the love casts out all fear. There is no reason to, right, be going around, because that's part of, here's another one to watch out for. If they express anything negative, as in they are always expecting the worst, that's a huge indicator as well they're living in fear. Okay, because when you're living in fear, that's going to trick a person into doing that, to continuously expect the worst, to go around looking for it, okay, expecting the worst. And we're like, no, that's negative. All right, so we always got to keep that in mind, if they're always expecting the worst. If you propose a logical and reasonable and reasonable. Thank you for your patience for me to get that out. Right, a logical and a reasonable solution to something that they claim to have an issue with, and you provide sound doctrine, and then they turn around and not only devalue that, all right, but they try to give you a bunch of different ways why that won't work. That's an indication that they're expecting the worst. All right, so what's the foundation for all of that? Yes, fear. So they're not aware. A lot of them are not aware of that. All right, so you know, and that's why you've probably heard some others refer to them as the scared little toddlers that they are. Okay, because they never outgrow that. They never outgrow it. And it's unfortunate, but again, we turn it over to God. All right, so a little bit shorter on this one because it's just a reminder and a refresher for those who needed it. And with some additional tip and things like that for you all on that one. You know, I guess you can call them little red flag, okay? As always, if you have any questions, you know where to reach me for additional information, insight, and other good stuff. Check out these videos right here. Sending love and light to all fellow warriors. Thank you for watching and for your support. Until next time, let's show that gratitude to the Heavenly Father. And you keep being you. In Jesus' name, amen.